Are you hearing this? Oh, yeah. Oh, man.
Now, right here at the end, say, you on the Bone Hampton Channel. After all that.
After all that.
You on the Bone Hampton Channel.
You on the Bone Hampton Channel.
One time, one world, two times, one love, three times, rewind, cause I'ma dedicate this song to everyone I got shooting.
Just like you be, it's the bumps and curves of our history, but no blocks in the road that we can't traverse, and no wounds from the past that can't be nursed. All hate gonna dissipate from our fate. No check together, we got a checkmate. All hate gonna dissipate and fade away to make room for a brand new.
Yes.
Alright, you're on the Bone Hampton Channel again, and I'm here with my girl, Elizabeth Hasselback. How you doing?
I'm good, how are you?
I am good. Good.
Nice.
Now,
thank you. Green trim in
thank
there.
You. Now, you don't know, I always tell people, when it comes up for me to come back on The View,
yes.
Right in line behind Sherry, Elizabeth Hasselback has my back.
That's right.
To have me back.
I do.
Now, we're going to talk about a couple of things. First of all, I told everybody that right before the show, I like to pray before I do anything.
Good.
And I normally try to grab Sherry, but they had Sherry hemmed up. So I grabbed you, and I was like, Elizabeth, would you pray with me? And you had this look like, ain't nobody ever guest host and asked me to pray. Yeah, I'll pray with you both.
Yes, please, let's.
So you are one of the, you may be the voice of Christianity on TV. There are some other actors that are Christians, but you are one that every day pretty much has to stand your position of your faith and what you believe.
I think Sherry might actually do a better job of that than
It depends on which Tuesday you catch me on.
I know.
A lot of times it feels like you're up there almost one against two, one against three, and you stand your place. Now, Sherry has told me you have a quote that you go by. Remember, an audience of one.
Yeah, that's the only thing that's kind of got me through, because I used to come here and look out at the audience and say something, and it was like, silence or daggers. And then I was always wondering and worrying about who I was making upset or who I was pleasing, and it drove me nuts. And then I thought, you know what? At the end of the day, if I go home and worry about pleasing one, then, and that's hard enough most days, you know.
Yeah, absolutely.
Then I can rest a little bit more easily and know that that's the most important job. No matter what you're doing, whether you're here, whether you're teaching, whether you're a doctor, whether you're a mom, a dad, whatever, that's enough. It's hard enough, and it is enough. So, audience of one keeps me coming back. Otherwise, you're never going to be enough for anybody. You're always going to let somebody down.
There's a lot of people, a lot of Christians, that try to figure out when they're at the workplace or they're dealing with friends that are not mm-hmm. Christians. Like, how do I do it without upset them? Mm-hmm. And what I found is a lot of people have watched you, and they're like, Elizabeth seems to have it, and that's why I wanted to talk about that, so they can hear firsthand from you. What is your mindset when you're sitting there and you're dealing with pros, pro debaters,
sure.
That's trying to get you tripped up and say that what you believe, something's wrong with it. And so that's Elizabeth Hasselback explaining that's how she do it. Now, you have
not always very well bone is the answer. I don't do that well often.
Well,
but you just, you know, I think what you can do is I try to, instead of telling someone what should be done or how it should be done, just get it done.
Can you talk about you change your heart? Don't change laws, change your heart. That's what I love.
You know, so I get a question a lot about pro-life versus pro-choice. Gay marriage comes up a lot. And I think always what I say is I'd rather change a heart than a law. Because a law is always depending on the person who is full of faults, like you and me, making that law, and the people passing that law. And they may be with you at times, and they may be not with you in terms of your beliefs. But I think if you can change hearts in terms of what is meant to be through God's eyes, then it doesn't matter what the law is or is not, if the heart is in the right place.
So, I love that.
Can I steal it? Once in a while.
Okay, I might even name my next DVD Change of Heart, Not a Law. I like that. All right, now, for the end, you have a clothing line?
Yeah, you know what, I grew up designing, went to school for design, so that's actually what I really do, which is cool, because if you, right, Sharon, let's us mm-hmm. do what we do outside of here.
And she makes it in a size 16.
I know. do. I have a line on QVC under their dialogue label, and then I'm also right now working on gluten-free products, the Ab Glider, and a line of fitness sort of lifestyle clothing.
And so what's the name of your book?
Oh, the book, G-Free Diet.
G-Free Diet.
The G-Free Diet, yeah. For celiacs out there, or those that want to be gluten-free, a little bit more healthy. You should try it. You go gluten-free?
I'm going to try gluten-free.
Okay.
I'm going to try gluten-free.
I'm going to hold you to that. I'm calling you later.
All right. This has been my girl, Elizabeth Hasselback. Every now and then, I call her Lizzie. Every now and then. And for those of you that don't know, her husband, Tim Hasselback, inspired my sweater vest.
Oh, that's right.
Okay. Because no, I don't wear no sweater vest, but Tim looked good. I'm like, you know what? Tim looked good. I think I had to flare mine up. You know, he had a solid. I had to get a little flash in there, a little flavor with some purple in there. But anyway, so thank you very much.
I love you.
This is Lizzie. I'm Bone. This is the Bone Hampton Channel.
Bone.
Give a kiss. Give a kiss. Come on. Give a kiss. Give a kiss.